Should we try the other one?
Wow!
Hooray!
Maybe they need to go down a bit.
It is one of your things. You're
that
quite right.
Is amazing. Wow! It's my magic, isn't it?
If I've got this right, I should be able to balance this on top of this. Let's have a go. Wonderful. And I can even give it a nudge and it remains completely balanced. However, if I take this sweet off and eat it, it goes all horribly wrong. Making sculptures like this is a great fun activity to do with your children, and it can also provide them with an opportunity to investigate balance and stability. Girls,
yeah.
Here's a challenge for you. See this piece of carrot? I want to see if you can balance this carrot on this stick on top of the bottles. Can you balance it?
No.
Try this one. Maybe it's this one. It doesn't really work too well,
does
it?
Bumpy.
Why don't you think it's working?
It's a bit bumpy.
So what about trying to poke the stick into the carrot at some point? But be careful, because the pointy end is a bit sharp.
It's exactly the same.
Exactly
really.
The same. So that's not help. It's not helping.
No.
Here's one that we made a little bit earlier. Now, shall we have a go and see if this balances?
Okay.
It's the same carrot, same stick, with a bit of an uneven end. And let's see if we can balance it. Aha. Do you want to have a go? See if you can make one like that. Have a look at it, my sweetheart, here. And should we try the other one?
Wow!
Hooray!
Let's see if that works.
Hooray! Wow. One, two.
Just let go.
Hooray!
Wow! By magic, isn't it? But how can they do it? Is it because of the weight?
The weight? And where is the weight? Is it the bottom or the top?
At the bottom and the top.
Look at this.
That is one of your things.
You're quite right.
Is amazing. How many are there? One, two, three.
When you have an object like a pencil and you try and balance it on your finger, it bounces when it's roughly in the middle. And this point is called the centre of mass or the centre of gravity. And you can think of it as the point at which the mass or weight of an object is evenly distributed up and down the pencil. Now, for this pencil, you can see that it is approximately in the middle. Oops. But for some objects, like a hammer, obviously a hammer is much heavier at one end than the other. So if you try to do it in the middle, there's no way that it would work. So the centre of mass, if I can get it quite right, is much near the heavier end. And I find this quite tricky because I've got small fingers. There we are. But for an object like this roll of masking tape, the weird thing is that the centre of mass is not within the object itself. That seems a bit weird, doesn't it? But if I put my finger under here, you can see it rolls off very easily. And that's because the centre of gravity is right in the middle of the object. And it's hard to get it directly above my finger. It wants to roll off either way. But if I put my finger here, as you all know from experience, dead easy to balance it. And the centre of gravity is right here underneath. And that's the secret to making a successful balancing sculpture, is to make sure that the centre of mass is underneath the point at which it is being balanced on the object. Have a go at that. If it's tipping over this side a bit too much, what do you think might be suited to this?
The balloon's lighter than the sweet. Oh, and also this side.
We can change the centre of mass of a balancing sculpture by adjusting the position of the various bits and pieces we put together to make it. That's really good, sweetheart.
Wow, look, I didn't this.
Oh, well done, darling, it's amazing. Understanding the science of stability and how things balance is important for lots of things like designing a building or making a sports car. Obviously today we haven't done anything quite as complicated as that, but these sculptures are a fantastic way to start your children thinking about some of those concepts.